che ci sono i tornei, un match con tutti i nuovi, la nostra passione, il nostro match, e se la unica tutta la stili, muovere alle ricrute, scrive właśnie zadowolnik Niemiec, no musiał zagrać aż 3 sety, końcówka drugiego seta, drugiej partii, no była chyba najlepsza reklama Badmintona, naprawdę znakomity na występ jednego drugiego zadowolnika, taka bardzo długo walczyli na wymianę, w końcu w tym drugim secie wygrał Turek, dalej w trzecim przeważył szale zwycięstwa na swoją korzyść, faworyzowany Niemiec. No a Kuder Stantosen, ten zawodnik duński, to człowiek, który zrewanżował się rewelacyjnemu Hiszpanowi Luisowi Dominguez-Pereirowi za porażkę w meczu półfinałowym w turnieju drużynowym o czasy Mistrzostw Europy Juniorów. Zrewanżował się Hiszpanowi później znakomicie spisał się w meczu przeciwko rozstawionemu z numerem drugim Tomie Juniorowi Popowowi, który jest reprezentantem Francji. To był bardzo szybki mecz, naprawdę pokazał całkowitą formę Adam Santosem i choć duży jest tutaj dostawiony dopiero z numerem 5, to z całą pewnością jest to równy rywal dla Niemca, i choć tutaj Niemiec jest faworytem, to możemy spodziewać się naprawdę co wyrównanego meczu wspaniałego widowiska sportowego. Czas zwrócić wszystkie rzeczy na kort telewizyjny, kort numer 1 i tam przed nami wywiał cyklistów w starcie dami z Niemcami.
And you are very welcome back. It's the second match of a Schedule 5 men's singles final time between top seed Max Weiskirchen of Germany. Furthest from the camera in black, the German, and nearest the camera and serving, Anders Antonsen of Denmark. Certainly in advance of this men's singles competition. This is the final that everyone wanted to see. Certainly one of the Danes against Weiskirchen. Rasmus Gemke failing in his attempt to win European Junior. The Dane just pulling a hamstring early in the team competition and just wasn't at his best throughout this individual, ending up having to retire. And then Antonsen took on the challenge on behalf of Denmark. Really, yes. Such an exciting talent, this young man. Training in our house, I believe, and first saw him as a young 14-year-old playing in the Danish-Denmark International Challenge up in northern Jutland in Frederikshavn, and really caught my eye on that occasion, almost getting to the qualification of a senior event. Against Weisskirchen, the German, always a little bit flamboyant, has this cocky air about him, but it's certainly not cockiness. Quite a lovely young man to talk to, but very confident in his own ability. And it's been a huge feat for all these athletes this week getting to this final. The draws are so big, 128 in singles. Against Anders Antonsen, it's been six rounds to get to this final.
Aktiv vorne mit draufbleiben.
Weisskirchen as top seed had that dramatic semi-final victory over Kurt of Turkey yesterday, was saved one match point to eventually come out on top, 23-21 in the deciding game. Before that, comfortably all the way through in two games, and a bit of a battle against Andy Tsai of Sweden in the quarterfinal, but winning it 16 and 24-22. Of course, Weisskirchen, another one of the players who's vying for double gold. Jakobsen failed after losing the women's single. She will be back in the women's doubles later. Weisskirchen looking to win this men's singles, and again alongside his partner Eva Janssens in the mixed doubles still to come.
Okay, genau, direkt ran, ja, direkt ran.
Anders Andersen in that prolific semi-final victory over Thomas Junior Popov of France, 21-13, 21-9. And has come all the way through to this final without dropping a single set. Really a phenomenal performance by the young Dane. And Hansen trying to emulate, of course, the win of Victor Axelsen.
In the middle, der war gut da.
In 2011 in Vantaa in Finland. And the German trying and attempting to go back to back European junior titles for Germany. You remember in 2013 in Ankara, Fabian Roth winning, beating Mark Kalju of the Netherlands in the final.
Yes.
So with Roth and Weisskirchen,
kommt drauf in die Annahme.
Certainly a strong future for Germany in men's singles. And Max, of course, who spent many years as understudy to Mark Zwiebler in his club in Germany. Antonsen, who is on the attack, and it's the Dane who gets to the interval lead first, 11-7. And Anders, you can see, quite animated on court when he gets into a lead. And Max Weisskirchen just a little bit more subdued, but certainly in that semi-final yesterday, the display of emotion after the Germans' victory over Kurt of Turkey was an indication of really how much Max wants to win this tournament. So 6 minutes gone, 11-7. Hope you're enjoying the TV quality pictures wherever you're watching, and of course the setup here in Lubin in this fantastic RCS arena, the first ever event, Badminton Europe event here in Lubin, and the organization and the willingness to make everything absolutely perfect by the organizing team, really second to none. And this is the first event that we've seen with these animated electronic advertising boards around the court. Such an atmosphere, such an arena for these young people to come and display their badminton skills. And every one of them have had nothing but good things to say about their time here in Poland. And really, new benchmark has been set, not for not just for junior events, but for senior Badminton Europe circuit events also. If this setup and this organizational quality was emulated around Europe at all the events we travel to and go to and see, we would certainly have a product second to none. Anders certainly felt that cross-court smash, that push down the line, was landed out. It looked well out. And this time a correct call from that line judge. Good call, smash down the line, just wide. Nice cut cross court from the German.
Missed time.
No head-to-head information between these two players, of course. Antonsen certainly visible in some senior tournaments this season on the Badminton Europe circuit. And did enough just to get a 5-8 seeding here at the European Junior Individual. Max more visible on the junior circuit, certainly German junior, Dutch junior, the A grade junior events.
Schau, dass du es einfach spielst. Komm rein in das Spiel. Spiel Ball wechseln.
Interestingly, Anders choosing to wear his country's colors today as opposed to his racket and equipment sponsors. Clothing. It's patriotic red today. Got a flame here, Dane.
Yes.
Certainly one way traffic in this opening game. It's Antonsen and his relentless quest to lift this European junior title. Of course, Anders, current European number 17 champion. Easy cross-court smash winner. Takes Antonsen to game point. In the end, little resistance from the German. And in just 10 minutes, Anders Antonsen races into a first game win, 21-9. As I said, Anders, the reigning under-17 champion, winning that title in Ankara in 2014. Enjoy some of the replays, the TV quality pictures here at the European Junior Championship final. An easy cross-court winner from Antonsen, no resistance whatsoever from the German. Expect Max to come out with all guns blazing in this second game. Really cannot afford to let his opponent get on the offensive. Antonsen playing with a lot of courage and certainly a lot of determination and skill. And if he gets a lead, he will build on that and most likely go on and take this title. So both players back on court. First set in just 11 minutes to Anders Antonsen, 21-9. Let's see what the German can do. The German team sitting behind me, shouting encouragement to their teammate. Opening points of this second game, crucial now for the German. That's the first point for Max Weisskirchen. Oh, great disguise and a little clip cross court from Anders. Yeah, certainly the wrong shot to play. A backhand smash. Barely reaching halfway up the net from Max. Little smile from Anders. Didn't expect the shuttle to come over the net, but an excellent shot from Max. Thought about playing little brush net kill, but felt the shuttle wasn't coming back over the net. Misjudgment really from Anders, and they come straight back out in the next rally with a beautiful return of serve for the winner. Certainly did everything right in that rally. A smash down the line, just out. Yeah, that serve from Anders just a little bit high, too much air over the net. Momentum of the shuttle, taking it over the net. Certainly. Weisskirchen just showing a little bit more of what he's capable of in this second game. Starting to settle into the match, I think, the German. Smash right into the body of Anders. little racket wave of apology from Max to his opponent. And again, better from the German, just letting himself down, turns to his coaches, hands in the air. Really is Max, who's playing the better badminton in the opening part of the second game. But it's just a few unforced errors from the German is keeping Anders right in touch. And that's a much better shot from the German. Nice disguise. Heavy slice, see the replay here. Anders Antonsen certainly felt it was out, certainly on top of it. Hard to tell, looked like it may have clipped the line. That's one thing you get with the juniors here. There's never really any arguments with umpires, line judges. They just get on with it, play the game. Enjoy it, and that's a super rally from Anders Antonsen, and all of a sudden, and the body language of the Dane, a lot more positive. Pinpoint accuracy, cross court with the smash. Three points in a row for the German. And this is much better play and much better attack from Max Weisskirchen. Took a little bit of time to really find his rhythm and expel the nerves that are bound to be there in a major European final, the biggest match, biggest event these young men have been involved in their badminton careers, and the setup that goes along with a major European championship, all to be taken in and absorbed. So there's a spirited fight back after that devastating loss at the opening game, 21-9. Fantastic play by the German. 5-point lead, 11-6, 20 seconds called by the umpire. Certainly looked out to me, but called in, and that's more than one occasion that line judge has made an error, in my opinion. We might get to see it on replay. That's two bad calls, but certainly it was one each, so the bad calls just tend to evening themselves out a little bit. Super backhand smash from the German. Certainly no doubt that time, well inside the line, the winner from Antonsen. bit of flat men's doubles.
Okay, to them.
In a row after the interval for the young Dane. A bit deceptive play. Pushing Antonsen onto the backhand side.
Come here.
Yeah, Max looks to the heavens. Going around the head, with that cross-court smash, all just a bit wild, just mistimed. Nice return. Really, the confidence which the German is now playing to take on that cross net, but his opponent staring him in the face was really measure the confidence of Max Weisskerken in the second game. Certainly the memories of the first game vanished. And again, the net from the German. Shift in a badminton match. Here's Antonsen. He looks so confident after the first game. Weisskerken just looking slightly dejected. But now we have this relentless onslaught from the German in the second game. Whereas everything went right for Anders in the opening game, it's now the German's turn to excel. So 16-10, first game to the Dane in red. This time, the net just letting Max Weisskerken down. Point in the second game, it's certainly time. If Anders Antonsen is thinking of winning this championship in two sets, certainly now needs to put the pressure on. Get on the attack. And that's a wild smash. Coach's hands in the air, looking for direction, looking for some words of inspiration, really. This is the first real test this week for the young Dane.
Bring it on us.
18-12, and the odds are that we'll be going into a third and deciding set. 25 minutes gone. And the further we go into this match, the more it looks like it could be a day for the German. Well, that's a better smash. Lift just a little bit short from Max, allowing Anders Antonsen to get a good steep angle on the smash for the winner.
Yeah.
Voilà, voilà, super, là.
Beispiel.
Service fault called against Anders Antonsen. Takes the German Max Weiskirchen to game point. 5 game points now for the German. Beautiful cross net off the floor again from Max. And that's it. Easy in the end for the German. Takes the second game, and what a spirited comeback from Max Weiskirchen. Looked down and out after the opening game when Antonsen was on his toes and everything going right for the Dane, but a really fantastic comeback from the German, getting out of the blocks quite well in the second game, going on to dominate and take the second, 21-15. We go to a deciding set in this men's singles final at the 2015 European Junior Championships. Certainly interesting to see how the young Dane copes with being taken to a third game, the first time this week in the individual event for young Anders Antonsen. As you enjoy the replays, some excellent net from the German. And really playing with huge confidence now, Max. One of the rare smash winners from Anders Antonsen in that second game. To the focused look of Max Weiskirchen, top seeded player here in the men's singles draw. Anders Antonsen already back out on court.
20 seconds.
Opening points so vital now for both men.
Yeah.
The German team getting behind their teammate. Danes, as always, just quite reserved. Nothing new, of course, for Denmark to be in and contending major championship finals. First blood in this deciding set to Anders Antonsen. That's a really nice, clever return of serve. Equally good return from Antonsen. Beautiful control of the shuttle, taking it nice and high at the net. Spinning shuttle coming down, very difficult to control for the German. Flick serve,
yep.
Way too short.
Schön getroffen.
That shuttle just lasting one rally. Yeah, it was really good block defense initially, and then the push into the body of Weiskirchen for the winner.
3-2.
Yes. Very good.
Again, another poor half-court lift from Anders, really. Max We'll gobble those half court. Oops. Lifts up all day, smashed them for winners.
Höhen sind da fit. Treffpunkte hoch.
Heavy slice from the German, but super defense from Anders Antonsen. Quick to get down to the shuttle, but equally quick to get back up. So many of the top players practice that nowadays. Speed of recovery off the floor. Lift just out from Max Weiskirchen.
Six four.
Good spell for the Dane. 3 points in a row. I think Max feeling.
Okay.
Yeah, you can see Max certainly thought that Anders lifted the shuttle on a half volley off the floor, and Antonsen protests. No real argument from the Danish coaches.
Yes.
Antonsen getting a little bit lucky in the return of serve, shuttle tipping the net court.
Wieder Ballwechselspiel.
Yes. Oh, super. Disguise. A little stopped.
Beine klar haben.
Net shot. Certainly Max Weiskirchen was fooled as I looked like Antonsen was going to lift. And a quick shuffle of the feet. And playing the net.
Come on, weiter beißen, Treffpunkte holen im Vorderfeld. Bleib aktiv.
What a fantastic rally from Anders Antonsen. Max Weiskirchen in attack throughout that rally. And superb defense, not just panicked defense, but controlled defense from the Dane. And in the end, beautiful smash winner. And you can see what that meant to Antonsen. You can see on screen already the organizers here welcome you next year. The under 17 junior championships taking place in this very arena. In this city next year at the same time, same week, so I'm told. The under 17s will have so much to look forward to coming here to Poland. The organization and the setup of this arena and these courts really second to none.
Klar på, han kommer igen her. Eh? Anders, klar på, han kommer igen. Eh? Så vi skal forberede på det, men vi skal udfordre at få en tid.
So 11-6, 5-point lead for Anders Antonsen. It's the young Dane in the driving seat in this final of the 2015 European Junior Men's Singles final.
This time,
Antonsen right awake at the net. And all of a sudden, there's daylight for the Dane. Two double action lifts from the German. Just seems that Max Weisskirchen just lost a little bit of concentration.
Yes!
We have to remember, of course, when Anders is focusing solely on singles here this week. Max has been threading the boards in both mixed doubles and singles. A lot of mileage on the clock for the German in this individual event. A little bit of variation in the serve. Flick serve from the Dane. Indecision from Max. Good rally. One feels this is a really big rally in the whole scheme of things in this match. And it's a German who comes out on top. Max just looking for a quick towel down. Change of shuttle required. So three feathers flying off that shuttle mid rally. And as you can see, both men now observing the new rule where you're not allowed to flick sweat from your brow. So both over, taking a quick towel down and back again to play. Certainly has speeded things up a little bit in the game. We used to have the situation where we'd have sweat on the flicked on the floor. It's a tactic and a lot of time wasting involved in the ensuing court maintenance.
And again,
you can see sometimes, and that's not the first time this match, when Max Weisskirchen goes around the head for that cross-court smash, just gets a little bit off balance. Terrible, terrible shot. Certainly, you will not win a European Junior Championships playing shots like that under no real pressure. Just looks like mentally Max has switched off. Better return and serve. And really, 10-point lead. And we're in three of the title. It's the Dane who looks more comfortable and more likely to go on and win. We've seen bigger comebacks this week. We saw in the women's doubles. for the Croatians at 7 match points against the Germans women's doubles in the quarterfinal.
You're not going to hold again here.
And save 7 and went on to win it in 3. So stranger things have happened this week.
There you go.
Double scores, and there you go. Here's the shot of a confident young man. And really, this young man, such a star for the future, has all the shots. Match point, Anders Antonsen, 29. Dejected looking Max Weisskirchen. And that's it. In the end, he does it. Anders Antonsen has done it. He is the European Junior Championship, following in the footsteps of Victor Axelsen, who won in 2011. The young Dane has claimed the title. First set he's dropped this week in the individual. Disappointment for Germany. Fabian Roth won it 2 years ago. Max Weisskirchen unable to win it this time. And a good second game, the German. But overall, it has been the Dane's week. He has been the outstanding player, outstanding men's singles player, and really what a star for the future, Anders Antonsen. We congratulate him. Stay tuned. The prize giving ceremony will follow, and then we'll be back with a third match of a Schedule 5. It'll be the men's doubles top seeds, Ben Lane and Sean Vendy, against number 2 seeds, Alexander Bond and Joel Eibep of Denmark.
Once again, let's move on to the medal ceremony. Men's singles competition, men's singles tournament. On the third place in this competition, representing Turkey, Muhammad Ali Kurt. And representing France, Thomas Tugyanov. Third place in men's singles competition. Now let's move on to the second place. On the second place, representing Germany, Max Weisskirchen. And let's move on to the new champion, new European Junior Champion, representing Denmark, Anders Antonsen. Will be given and presented by Vice President of Badminton Europe from Turkey, Murat Üstekik. Thank you. Wielki brawa, Andres Santos, Serbia. Jeśli teraz pomyślicie chwilkę na fotoreporterów, nadal na uwieczcić tych mistrzów, tych najlepszych zawodników w kategorii singlistów w tej konkurencji, no, drugi złoty medal zdobywa Dania. Zobaczymy, czy dzisiaj będziemy jeszcze w stanie usłyszeć jakieś inne hymny, czy też Duńczycy tutaj zdominują tę rywalizację. Przypomnę, przyjmili reprezentanta Danii w każdym z pozostałych finałów, już za chwileczkę finał męskiego dębla. Thank you very much, and in a second we will move on to the presentation and introduction players in men's doubles final. Presentation, introduction of the men's